हेलो 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 एवरीबॉडी.
हाय प्रियंका दीदी, हाय स्मृति दीदी,
हेलो हेलो. वी जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर आवर गेस्ट टू कम.
स्मृति दीदी म्यूटेड, स्मृति दीदी म्यूटेड है यहाँ पर।
यस स्मृति, यू आर म्यूटेड.
हाय कविता, ऋषिका, अनीता, खुशी, प्रिया एंड वी आर लाइव।
या वी
हाय
आर लाइव.
स्मृति दीदी,
सो यू नो टुडेज टॉपिक इज वेरी
हाय।
इंटरेस्टिंग फॉर मी आल्सो. यू जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर द
या
गेस्ट.
एंड यू नो व्हेन आई टोल्ड सुरुचि अबाउट दिस टॉपिक एंड शी वाज लाइक जंपिंग विद जॉय। ओ दिस इज अ टॉपिक आई लव टू टॉक अबाउट। सो आई थॉट हाउ डज इट गेट एनी बेटर देन दिस।
Yeah, so before she's coming, you know, she has won Mistress India pageant. She's the winner
Yeah,
of Mrs.
yeah.
India 2000, I think,
She
17.
has. Yeah, 2017. We'll talk to her about that. Let us know when she won the contest.
Yes, exactly. So
So welcome, Kavita, Jadhav, Payal. Hi Taruna.
Hi, Smriti.
Hi.
Okay, by the time she's coming, can you just share, did you ever heard about this 5 levels of intimacy before access?
No.
Not
And
before access. Surely not. No.
exactly. So, you know how beautifully they have explained in this, in the books they have written and everywhere. Like, the 5 levels of intimacy is honor, trust, respect, gratitude, and alliance. And, you know, when you have that in your life with yourself, you can invite other people to have that with you also. And, you know, it's a totally different way of having a relationship or living within a relationship, you know. When we live in with these five levels, relationship has a completely different the relationship is in a completely different level, I would say. What you say in this movie?
And because when I read this topic about this 5 elements of intimacy, it just boggled up my mind. And I really felt that, oh, is it, can we have these 5 levels with ourselves? Because we in this world where we live, we are always being taught, to help others, to love others, never to judge others. But never did we realize that among others, it's we who come first. And I think in this reality, we are the ones, we treat ourselves the most neglected person on this planet. And when I read this, and this book followed with the book I also recommend, Being You book also. So guys, I would highly recommend to you read all these books, and this will really give you an insight, and this will help you to connect you with yourself.
And
And
you know, when you have 5 minutes of intimacy with
yourself.
yourself, your relationship with not only just with your partner, but everybody changes, you know. And I have seen that changing in my life, because right now I don't have a partner, but I have so many the other people around me. So, you know, I have see the change in their behavior. Then I started, having 5 levels of intimacy with my own self. When I treated, respected myself, I had a gratitude for myself. I really saw the changes in the people around me. Whether they were my parents, my brother, my close family people, or my friends, even my friends, I have seen the changes in all of their behavior. you know, this is what I learned after coming to Access Only, ki, when you start to love yourself first, things changes. People changes. They start loving you more. They start having honor and respect for your presence in your life as you are, without changing any part of you. Yay, finally Suruchi is here. Hello Suruchi, welcome, welcome, welcome.
Hi Priyanka, thank you so much.
Welcome.
Hi Smriti, thank you.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you guys?
Good, good. Thank you so much for being here today on the call.
Pleasure. Thank you so much.
So guys, before we go ahead, I would like to introduce Suruchi. Suruchi is a certified Access Consciousness Facilitator and offer classes and personal sessions playing with the tools of Access Consciousness for living a life of ease, joy, and glory. She is an artist, a mother of beautiful two boys who is always seeking to create more in each area of her life too. She believes in going about life with ease and fun. As for her, life is to be celebrated every moment. Wow. Using Access tools have brought a deep level of change in her relationships for the first time. She had tools to create relationship that was so authentic, caring, fun, and expansive. So here's a question from her to all of you, that what possibilities can we be an invitation to that would create phenomenally for everyone on our dear planet Earth with ease, joy, and glory? And one more thing which Priya would like to add about her, Suruchi. Yes, Priya, please go ahead.
She has won Mrs. India pageant. So which year was that, Suruchi?
2018.
And I remember you sharing that in one of the Access classes, like how you were being you just there. And by that only, you know, you had impressed. I think you won the contest, basically.
I won the contest.
But just being you there.
Yes.
So I would like you to share some of your experience of that contest and how Access has turned your life.
So, first of all, thanks to Access, because if it wouldn't have been Access, maybe at the age of 40, appearing for Mrs. India contest would not have been possible. Because, see, sometimes 40 is not the age where you are very high about yourself or you have a very high opinion about yourself, your body, your figure, whatever it is, right? If we would have been in our teens or 20, we are at the best self, like how we judge ourselves in the past and like, oh, my body was so perfect then, oh, this and that. But luckily, it was like, can you embrace yourself for who you be, your body and everything? And then luckily this contest showed up and it was just a general casual conversation I was having with my husband, and we were going about to go for a party. I said, hey, this dropped up. I'm applying for it. And he jokingly said, yeah, yeah, why not? As if you'll get selected. I said, okay, fine. And just applied for no right reason and went off. And all of a sudden, then another round of questionnaire came up and things like that. So it was actually a fun thing where I was not vested in the result, which I shared earlier. It was like not vested. It was like having fun and flowing with that. Hey, you, because I think out of all of us and all the women, somewhere when we look that Bollywood movie or when we see this contest or thing, we always wanted, I wish I was there. That wish list is always in our kind of bucket list somewhere, right? So it was that kind of a bucket list was somewhere subsided, and coming from a Marwari family where I'd been given a lot of freedom. I will not tag Marwari family for not giving my freedom or my parents for not giving, because I took part in a lot of fashion shows and things like that. But it was never, it's like go out and make that as your career or something. So it was very liberating in the sense is like, hey, you're going to fulfill your dream after having two boys and where your husband is supporting you and all that. And I think I didn't even tell my parents or anybody that I have applied. It was only between me and my husband that I had applied. And it was like, okay. I was like, okay, let's go. So it, I only disclosed it to everybody when at the last stage where I had to ask for votes and then I had to go public about it. And in my life, I've never covered anything or kept anything under wrap because my stomach pains. I need to blurt it out. But it's a beautiful thing just for me, just for fun. Don't tell anyone. So I was following that tool. I was having fun with it. Only a few close people with had, like, I had shared, but I had not shared. So the day if I had to go pub, like I had to go announce publicly and ask for vote. So that day I called my parents and said, before I go public, I need to tell you, hey, I had applied for this and I'm in the final round.
So how were they? What was their reaction?
I think they were not very surprised because I've been a very independent child from childhood, but still they were like, are you sure you really want to do this? And I was like, listen, I'm in Indore right now facilitating a foundation class and I'm just telling you because I'm going to go public about it, asking for vote, and I don't want you to get this information from a friend, family, that, hey, you didn't tell Suruchi is taking part in this pageant. So it was kind of, but because somewhere, thanks to Access, there was no judgment or a guilt in the space. I was not hiding that I was guilty or ashamed of. I was hiding it or not sharing it because I just wanted to have fun with my own self, where I didn't want people's opinion to come in my way of something that they feel is, this is not the age, this is not the time, or this is what you're not, why are you doing this kind of a feeling. And so it was just from that space that I didn't share it. But yeah, it was like, are you sure? I said, yes. So it's like, see, as a mother now, I can say, it's like, if my son has already done it, I don't have any piece of advice left to give it to him. I say, okay, great, do it. Go ahead and do it. Because the boat has already sailed.
Yeah, so Suruchi, there must be, your journey for this contest has always been, I think, must be kind of a roller coaster ride also. So can you tell to us that what kind of tools you used to use of Access at that moment of time to bring ease at that, during that period?
My beautiful mantra was, all of life comes to me with ease, joy and glory. Because actually that time, the duration, it was so juggling. Like when I look at it, I actually laugh because they had asked us to make a video and things like that. And I think I may have taken it too lightly or what. I really didn't know because I thought it's for their own personal view. They will not going to showcase in the pageant. So yeah. I remember going down because I have a good compound down and holding my maid, take this camera and please record. I need to send something. She's like, sure, Didi. I said, yeah. So I said whatever I need to say. And it was basically, I wanted to share how the journey is going and everything. And when I saw that it was showcasing on the pageant day, and then people took so much pain, effort, and everything they did to put that piece together. But somehow when you're having fun and when you have no reference point, because I didn't Google what you're supposed to be and do. And in that moment, you go into that shock. You're like, shit, what did I do? Why didn't I put that? But at the same time, you were just being you, the energy of being you, whatever you thought was required, whatever you thought was needed, and you just flowed that energy. So my video only had that energy of me being there with my vulnerability, but it doesn't have like a nice backdrop or like flowing, and it's like, it doesn't have that presentation, if I have to say. So it was hilarious. And it's like a morning, and then my friend said, hey, if you're going, give you 100%. I said, you know what's the best about? The weight is not the criteria. They're looking at me. They're like, I said, no, I don't want to go up there at like 34, 24, 36. I'm not that. And then if that is the thing, I don't want to. And luckily, I never got the mail where they said that, hey, we will only choose people on the first or second position or something if you are a particular weight or a particular size. And because it was not in my demand, in my mailbox, I never got that mail. I only got to know once I was there. So it's like, what the idea is, what is your ask? And if you're true to your ask, nothing that can, that will not allow you to fulfill your desire will come in your way. So those mails never reach to me, the opinion or point of view that I need to do this presentation or this video in a certain way never crossed my mind. So I'm not saying don't take it seriously, but I'm saying is like when you're in sync with your ask, everything, your point of view, which can make you reject those things, just disappear from the universe. I only got to know like last day where I remember one of my participants, she was sharing room. She looked at me, she's like, what the hell are you doing? I have never seen such insincere person in out my life. You were like, as if you were just playing. I said, yeah, I have come to play. She's like, what the hell? We've been starving. We've been doing this. We've been preparing for 2 years. You just can't come and take the cake and walk away. So I was like, I've been preparing, but in a different way. I've been preparing energetically. You've been preparing physically. I've been preparing energetically for God knows 10 years or more. So it's like honesty, vulnerability, the theme, the intimacy, that the theme that we are talking about, the intimacy with the self. So at that time, I had that energy of intimacy with myself. And thanks to access that allowance, I had major allowance for myself because I would have gone wrong. If the same Suruchi fast, maybe if I do rewind back to some 15 years back, I would have gone into guilt. I would have gone into shame. I would have judged myself. I would have wronged myself. I would have done anything possible, or I would have fought. I would have fought for that position. But in this case, I was not fighting for that position. I was just playing to have that position. And one of my friends had to remind, hello, it's a competition. You're supposed to win, okay? I said, yeah, okay, fine. She like, okay, go there, win. I said, okay, I'll go and win. So it's just that.
How cool is that? And I'm feeling so light when you are talking this, Suruchi, because when I came into Access, you know, I also wanted to make my FB page or Insta page, and I made it. But for months, you know, I just used to click it and I used to click it off because it took me months, probably 6 to 8 months, to come out of the fear that, okay, if I'll be on live or if I'll be on Insta or people will judge me, they will, you know, I need their validation. What they, if they will reject my facilitation. So, you know, when I was going through the Being You book, I was reading about these five elements of intimacy, that I have to be in total allowance, gratitude. I have to be vulnerable with me. Then that was the time, you know, when it actually happened. And I then decided, okay, now it's time for me also, you know, to go live.
To be seen by the world.
Yes. Yes.
No, Swati, so beautifully said. It's like if the day we don't judge ourselves, trust me, nobody will. Yeah, they get scared of you. They actually get scared of you. They're in awe of you. What's wrong with this person? They're trying to figure it out and they can't label you.
Yeah. So I would like you, I'm inviting you to talk more on this five levels or level of intimacy and how it can create, you know, more beautiful relationships in our lives.
See, since childhood, my only desire or demand was I wanted people to be intimate with me, people to love me, to nurture me, to care me. Okay. That has been a rut. That has been a stubbornness in me that I want people to give this to me. And we all go, we all look for that friend, we look for that boyfriend, we look for parents' love, sibling love, where we are ready to cut our parts, pieces, everything. Please love me, please like me, please appreciate me, please validate me. And it's a story of everybody, whether it's a man or a woman. It's a story of everyone because we feel, okay, I'll be valued more or I can value more if people value me. So we are looking what price tag to put on ourselves depending on our demand. And that demand, right? So, but then the thing is, the irony is, if we don't value, however beautiful the product is, people don't value it. And so the price is 000. It's like any artist, if you see, any designer you see, any piece of work you see, when you see there's something beautiful, but still you don't pick up, and there's something you like it and you kind of pick it up. And if you just take a minute and ask, okay, when the person was creating this, what was the person's energy with it? Were they happy with that creation? Were they dissatisfied with their creation? Were they judging their creation? So it's a beautiful piece, but you don't pick it up because you can pick up that judgment of the artist or the designer or whoever created. They were judging them. They were not too sure about their creation. And that's the reason we like it. But something says not this. And a very simple painting you pick up, or a very simple clothes you pick up, and you're like, oh, wow. And the other person is like, what's so wow about it? You're like, no, but I really feel so nice when I wear it. It feels so good. Why? Because when the person made, they looked at the creation and says, wow, I'm such a fabulous artist. It's so amazing. And that was the energy that the piece contained. And that's what you witnessed, right? See, when we look at objectively at other things, we all get it. Now, imagine you walking that ramp. Imagine you walking in that party. Imagine that you're walking in your boardroom. Imagine that you're meeting a client. What is your current state of mind with yourself? Are you judging you? Are you loving you? Or in between?
This I have totally witnessed. I can say that, you know. When I was judging, yeah, so everybody was like, not. When I was in total alliance of me and sexual and sensuous about myself, trust me, in that day, everybody was looking at me like, okay, this is actually happening. So, and you know, you beautifully shared this, ki, we go with the energy what the artist has made that thing with. You know, we never realized and we was never able to put that in words, but now you have like beautifully put that thing in words.
So you are the artist of your own creation. You are your own creation. So, and every day that creation will look different because every day your energies are different. But yes. Then how much we are ready to judge ourselves?
A lot.
So it's like you are not what you were yesterday. Why are you trying to hold on to your past? So half of our life go fighting the past, because if you go back to your past picture and if you get back, then also you were judging because you were then again going back to another past. So what about you? Why, what will it take for you to honor yourself for who you are today? Today I have a fight and you're trying to tell me to smile. I'm honoring my feeling. I'm feeling bad. And what's wrong about that?
But everybody around will say this is wrong. You should not be feeling anger or crying. Or...
God says don't judge. Are we following that? God says share. Are we sharing? No. See, we do what suits us, right? It's easy to blame people, but we only do what suits us. So how judging you suiting you is the question. Forget what people say. How judging yourself is helping you?
Not at all.
No, it is helping. Believe me. Trust
me, helping to be in the trauma and drama.
A, to be in the trauma and drama. B, we feel if we judge a little bit more, we will succeed in breaking something. What? Breaking another big box of judgment? Or cracking another label?
So sometimes it's like competition also. Wo mere se zyada dukhi kaise ho sakti? I have to be more.
Great. So it's like, fine. So maybe then become the queen. Na? In that moment, become the queen of drama queen, the biggest drama queen. So when you get over the drama, you can choose something different and be vulnerable. Yeah, I'm being a drama queen. That's a vulnerability with yourself. That, hey, I'm choosing to be this. Then I don't need a facilitation. Then I don't need to prove people wrong. I'm just choosing to be in this energy. I'm choosing the drama and trauma because I so love the soap opera. Like, I'm the biggest drama queen. I did theater. And now because I can't do theater, I bring theater in my classes because I love it.
So So Ruchi, often, the girls, and here I think I can sense the energy, a lot of girls I know, they come up with the thing that being so-called lovey-dovey couples, they are, but sometimes, you know, their partners doesn't allow them, or so-called they don't give them permission to do something. And then they continuously judge themselves for that. And then they go into that trauma and drama. And so at that point of time, what piece of advice would you like to give them?
See, the thing is, when you're with somebody, okay, there are two spaces that we're maintaining. So if you operate from, hey, I, me, myself, it's kingdom of I, if you do, then why are you in a relationship in the first place? Let's not have a relationship, okay? Because see, for anything to, it's like, the car have two sides of the wheels. You need to balance both. So if I have to choose, I choose from the creator kingdom of V. If I do, will it create greater? Even you don't know, if you get the energy, yes, it will create greater growth. It doesn't mean to sabotage you. See, the thing is, when I'm killing myself to make my partner happy, my expectation is that he will also kill his desire and need to make me happy. Okay? Because I am not from a space of gifting. I'm in a space of giving. So I gave you 100 rupees, Smriti. Tomorrow, I'm expecting 101 with the interest. And that's where the fight goes. But I just gifted you 100 rupees. Whether you give me or not, it doesn't matter, because I was just in love in that moment. Tomorrow, will I gift you? Maybe not. In that moment, I was feeling so happy. So I just gifted you. So it's like when you have a fight, when you have an expectation, what are you expecting? Are you doing something based on expectation or based on fear? Or are you just doing it because you feel like doing it?
So can you explain the fear factor here?
The fear factor is, it's like, what is an underlining? Why do we need validation? What is an underlining? We have a fear. If people don't approve me, then I'm not good enough. I'm not a good product in the market. I'm not a good facilitator. So that's the reason we wanted everything to be perfect, right? Because it's a fear. So what have you judged yourself that you fear that people will see that we need to hide? Because we fear something, we fear that people will see the true me. So that's the time a lot of people be very rude, and deep down they're very kind-hearted people, but they don't want, because they have a point of view. If I'm too kind, people will walk over me. The people will treat me like a doormat, or I've seen my mother or father or whoever. They were so kind and people just took them for granted. So that is the fear, that people will take you for granted. You cover up by being rude. Sometimes you have a fear that, oh, I'm not good. I got a trophy husband or a boyfriend or a partner or a wife. I need to do everything, otherwise she will or he will leave me. Right? So you need to get is like when you're covering up or when you're doing extra, what is that underlining point of view you have about yourself? Once you get clear with that, be honest with that. You know, why are you attracting those situations? Because that is your trigger point.
Okay. Thank you.
And that's why we don't choose from kingdom of we choose from kingdom of I, because I need to cover myself. I need to hide myself. Otherwise, this will be seen. If I do it from kingdom of we, even my husband doesn't get. And if it feels light, I will go ahead and do it because I know he'll get it one day or the other. Because I chose from the space of we and not from I. Like for me and my husband, we have completely different points of views. But the beauty is like, he trusts me for who I am and I trust him for who he is. I know what he will do and what he'll not do, and he knows that I am a mad hatter who will go and do everything stupid. He trusts me to do stupid. It's interesting. Am I stupid? Yes. But am I serious? Yes. But it is like, whose lenses are you seeing yourself that you're fighting to cover those underlining fear that you have decided that you are?
And sometimes, you know, I start operating from the world of give and take a lot with my husband. You know, okay, I have given him freedom, or I have given him space for doing some things, then I expect, you know.
Why did you give him space? Because you wanted him to say, she's my bestest wife I have. It's a label that you like, right? It's a judgment that you like.
No, maybe I believed in give and take. Okay, I'll give him, so he will also give me.
We give beggar. Does beggar give us anything back?
No.
Okay. We give punishments to people. Do we expect punishment back?
No.
When we're angry, we slap our kids. Do we slap back, return? That kids will slap us back?
No.
Right? So why with husband? And we can't say it's a habit, because if it's a habit, habit will go with all across age, gender, whoever it is. We're very, see, a lot of times we say, we are so angry, I can't control my anger. My question is like, do you shout in front of your boss? Do you shout in front of your client? No. So why you do it with kids? Why you do it with your husband or wife, right? That's a comfort zone, because you know they will not return it back. So with you coming back, give and take, it's like, what is your agenda behind giving freedom and space? Because if you're so feeling bad, there's an agenda. And when that agenda doesn't get fulfilled, you say, hey, I gave him so much and I get nothing in return. So are you that broker who earn money in interest? If that is your profession, that's the reason you're doing give and take in your head. What will it take to gift? And when you gift something, you don't know whether you'll return. Because when you're gifting it also and the person receive, that is where you receive it. The love, which is unspoken, which doesn't come in form of gift or words. But when you give somebody a space, their happiness contributes. You receive their happiness, the joy that you're seeking. Like, for example, when the mother gave birth to a child, she goes through all the pain, all the thing. But when she sees it, is that happiness, right? That is not give and take, that is gifting and receiving. She gifted something in the world and she received the pure bundle of joy in that arm, and it melted all her pain and suffering in that moment. But I can curse after 1 year, what the hell, my life is ruined. But in that moment, it's gifting and receiving. So when it comes to husband or anybody else and you're doing give and take, ask, what is your agenda behind, which doesn't allow you to be gifting and receiving simultaneously? Because gifting and receiving happens simultaneously.
Wow, thank you so much, so much, Suruchi. So like, here I have to be in total allowance of who he is.
Yeah, you see, to be in allowance of someone, first you have to be in allowance of yourself. If you're a biggest critic of you, that becomes a nature, and we like to criticize people in name of love.
Yeah.
So it's like, what you don't have, how can you give something?
True.
So that's the reason it starts with self. What will it take for me to have allowance with myself? And when I build that muscle with myself, it's easier to have that same rule for others.
So here, what do you say about allowance with self? Like, we generally see ourselves with the eyes of others, from the eyes of others.
So what will it take for you to start seeing from the eyes of the universe? From the self also, I'll not say. It comes from self, but self is filled with so many layers of glasses. I really don't know exactly what self looks like, okay?
Exactly, yes.
So I don't know, because when I was born, somebody says I'm cute. When I was four, somebody says I'm not even. I was six, somebody says, oh my God, Tufan. Right. So if I start putting those glasses and seeing myself, I still have judgment. But if I see myself from the eyes of the universe, try this exercise. Look into the mirror and see, hey, how does the universe sees me? And just gaze at the mirror. Just keep gazing at the mirror. You will be uncomfortable. It's very difficult to do, but keep doing. You will see something very different that you would not be able to see if you see. And try it. If I see myself with my eyes, if I see myself as my mother's eyes or anybody's eyes, see. And it's amazing, you know what? Why? So if you ever go to dressing room, they have those full-size mirror, okay? Yeah. How many times when you look at the mirror, you find something odd. You'll say, this is looking hard, this is... Why? You will judge and you'll be amazed. You're like, why am I judging? It's perfect. Even a thin, lean person judges. Okay. Why? Because that dressing room have so much vibration of so many people changing clothes and with their judgment that has kind of stuck in that place, that when you go there, you kind of get merged with those vibrations. So your vibration with your body is no longer there. It's like a it's like a layers of other people's thoughts, feelings, emotions, like a puddle, right? And yes, that time, yes. Depending upon what you're feeling, you pick up those vibrations. Similarly, when you, I said, like when you look into the mirror and see from your eyes, because you have so many other people's thoughts, feelings, emotions, belief that has been implanted and explanted into your universe from the time you were born, we really don't know what is my eyes look like if I have to see me. So that's the thing is, like when you look into the mirror, see from the eyes of the universe and see what difference does it feel, how your body feels, how you look. Like sometimes when you don't have a judgment and look into the mirror, you're like, ah, I'm looking so pretty today, okay? And you walk on. And after something happens and you look, maybe in the elevator, there's a mirror and you look and you're like, shit, my God, my lipstick, oh, it's so bad. Why did this happen? In the morning, you were feeling pretty. Lipstick should make you even more prettier. Why? Because whenever you put that shade or whenever you have ever first put that lipstick, the judgment that was implanted and explanted to you that, hey, you know what? Lipper doesn't suit you or you don't know how to put lipstick or it's too much. Those thoughts also come when you're looking into the mirror. So it's just not your thought. It's a combination of other people's projections at you whenever you had applied makeup or what, or worn that dress or whatever it is.
So so that is the reason why when we are in the changing room, we were confused a hell lot, ki acha lag raha hai ya nahi, you know, what I need somebody's validation to select this dress now. Because at that moment, I'm not able to decide.
It is. Because the thing is, see, a lot of times when you pick it up, you're not sure. And when you wear it other day somewhere else, and with the environment where people are not judging you, you look the gorgeous. You look the best. And even if you have worn the best dress and everything, you have no extra inch of fat, okay? But still, the joy in you is missing. Why? Because you can perceive so much judgment around you. You're not being you. You're just trying to figure out the right way to be with this person, the right way to carry your dress and everything.
Yes.
So it's a myth.
So what can we do in that moment?
So when you're picking up clothes, then how about, why are you wearing clothes? You're wearing clothes for your body, right? So how about asking your body, hey body, what clothes would be fun to you for you to wear, which will bring out the sexualness, which will bring us more of us? And just wear it. It's like, you, if you give your body to help you contribute, it will. But you need to be vulnerable with your body. You need to honor your body. You need to trust the choices the body is making. So where that element of trust come in. That are you willing to trust your body to show you? Because you're ready to trust the entire nation, but you're not willing to trust yourself.
Yes.
Because if I said, Priyanka, you're looking so pretty, so pretty, so pretty, so pretty, so pretty, you'll be like, oh, wow. Right?
Yeah.
But if you look in the mirror and says, just the thought of, oh, I look so pretty. In 2 minutes, you'll go in doubt. So why is my opinion have that authority or have that reinforcement rather than your own opinion about yourself?
That is what I ask. You know, we never looked ourselves in that way. We always look like, okay, so she told me I was pretty, so I'm looking pretty now, you know. And the other person told me this, so I am like that.
Are you willing to be that other person for yourself 24/7? Are you willing to see yourself the way others sees you? Are you willing to give yourself that permission and trust your own knowing about you? What works for you and what doesn't work for you? Are you willing to trust that and be that vulnerable and honest with yourself?
Yes.
That's the key. Like you have to ask, okay, why will I not trust myself and why will I place my life in the hands of others? because you've decided, you've concluded, you have judged that you are wrong, because people projected, expected, and implanted and explanted into the universe, you're so silly, you make wrong decision, you don't know, you have no judgment, you don't know the world, you are naive, you are foolish, you're selfish, and blah, 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 blah.
The list is very long.
Then it can all come up. You know, when I was 4, my mom made me wrong. When I was 8, this person made me wrong. When I was 14, my first boyfriend, he broke up because I had a pimple. And you know, when I had 20, I didn't get married to this guy. So we have a list. Great. But do you ask yourself, who was the common factor in all different people? You. So what did you decide about yourself at that time that people were just reflecting that mirror in front of you?
This is such an eye-opener. Seriously. Who were the common person in all, every time? Yeah, it was me. Yeah.
So it's like, what if you just change your inner dialogue with yourself and says, I love myself with my flaws. So what, I'm fat. I love it with my thighs, so what, it's big. I love myself with my curly hair, so what, it's rough. I love me for who I am. If you like it, great. If you don't like it, pay, I'll go to the parlor. It's like, I see, when you don't have a judgment of you, nobody can make you wrong. Otherwise, it's like, I like going to the parlor. And if you're unhappy, you don't like my dress, can we go shopping? Can you buy me one? I don't mind wearing nice clothes. But how we, see, when you don't have a judgment, you can joke around, you can have fun, you can say this. But when you have a judgment, you go in your head that moment and like, why did the person say this? Shit, am I looking bad? Is this dress bad? And next time you'll not wear that dress. Next time you'll not do that hairstyle. Next time you will not do. You rejected everything that your body wanted to look like, or you wanted to experiment because somebody didn't approve of that.
And it happens all the time. Yes.
But then the thing is, you have to say, hey, do I approve of me? That's the one question. Hey, do I approve of a look? Yes, great. Let's go kill it. That's it. Otherwise, you'll always be a follower. You'll never be a leader. And we all desire to be a leader in our life. So you have to choose. You want to be in a back seat where people navigate your life, or you want to be in your driver's seat where you navigate your life?
Obviously in the driver's seat.
Obviously, we all know the answer. But what are reasons and justification for not choosing that? Then again, we can judge. I know the answer. Still, why do I write it wrong?
Another form of judgment begins.
Yeah. So what if I can have allowance that, hey, I know, I'll get it. We all are work in progress. So what is the deep desire or deep rooted point of view I have? It doesn't allow me to follow or trust my knowing about myself. The moment you trust your knowing about yourself, you are at the driver's seat. Even taking a wrong turn, you'll be in allowance that, oh, silly me, I made a wrong turn. No problem. I'll take a U-turn. It's like a little detour.
Yes, totally. Okay, so another question Priyanka have. How to in allowance of others who always do bad to me, and how to feel gratitude for bad things. And we can't make distance from them for some reasons.
So why, first of all, why have you given permission to people? You have given permission to treat you badly. So why have you given them permission to treat you badly? See, there are a lot of people, because if we are in a relationship, suppose they are in-laws, they are close-knitted friends, sibling. But then the thing is, hey, giving you permission, I will not cut from you, but I will set boundaries. Where are you not willing to set boundaries? This work for me and this doesn't work for me. Are you willing to be that sweet? I'm so thankful for your caring. I know you love me so much. That's the reason you care for me. Are you willing to manipulate them rather than fight them? And say, thank you. I love your caring. Thank you so much. You've given them the job. Now next time they have to care. Or if it's a mother or a father, thank you so much. I learned so much from you. Everything I am today is because of you. So is that? And it's like, see, people can only hurt us when we give them the permission to hurt. And those are very selective few, right? Nobody else comes. So what have you decided that if you will not allow that person to hurt you will happen? What is that underlining fear? Because if there's no fear, will you let anybody hurt you? I'm sorry, we become the Chandi in the same time. We become Durga in the same time. And we become the Kali in the same time. So it is not that we don't have those energies. So if we are powerhouse of goddesses, so you have to understand why you become a cow there. What is the deep down agenda you have, or what is that you fearing will happen? Because if you fear, if you decide, you will create it. I hope, Priyanka, that helps, because you need to get very present in the sense is like, why are you giving somebody permission to hurt you and how is that helping you? Somewhere we also have a belief that I need to be punished. And it's very weird, but we have that deep thing that I need to be punished because I've done something wrong. And that's the reason we invite people who keep punishing us emotionally, physically, mentally, or financially.
So, okay, we invite people to punish us. You know, there's a question in me. So this is how karma works, because we think I have done something wrong or something bad will happen to me.
Okay, tell me one thing. You did 1 month back something. Do you remember what you did?
No.
You did. You don't, right? But today I say, hey, I want to slap you. You know, remember 1 month back when I met you in the coffee shop? You treated me badly? Huh? That's the reason I'm giving. It's a reason and justification for my action. I don't remember what the shit I did next. I don't remember what I did a year back. You're talking about another lifetime. How much that is an excuse? Are you willing to choose something different? Are you saying, hey, this doesn't work? Or are you going, yes. Okay, tell me one thing. Your mom gifted you a very beautiful sari, okay? But it was in 40s. Will you wear that every day? It's karma, it's love, yeah, mom's love, yeah. Please wear it, whether if it's outdated also, please wear it. You will not, you'll make a choice. You'll say, hey, it's nice, let me cut it and make it into a dress. I don't wear sari. You'll cut it, right? You'll make it what works for you. So why will you not choose a life that works for you? Why are you blaming karma? Why are you? Because you are not willing to choose. So karma is a nice reasons and justification.
Blame.
It's a reason and justification. You can blame it because we don't want to see that we are the creator. Like, yeah. Hey, I don't have a money. I'll blame it on my karma. You know, I'm very hardworking. I still don't have money. But my question will be like, do you love money? You say, of course, I love money. What you're saying? Fine. If you love money, then why don't you have money? How many times when you decided something to have it, all of you go back, jog your memory. You had that as your reality. And when you're not having something, it's like how much you are just using as an excuse to say, blame it on somebody. If you are the creator and something is not working in your life, why won't you just delete it and ask those energies, create those things that works for you. But if you blame it to karma, then karma has to come na, to create that again. You're not the creator, so you cannot change it. So you keep waiting for karma, maybe next lifetime, maybe another lifetime. Or you say, I don't know which lifetime, whether I was a witch or a saint, I am choosing to have this in this lifetime and I will do whatever it takes to have this as my reality. So that is taking a ownership, that is being a creator, that is sitting on your driving seat and driving the car, even if it's 250 kilometers ahead, but choosing to go at whatever speed you can go and whichever car it is. Then you will not say, oh, I have a Maruti and it's a bumpy road, I need an SUV. You're like, fuck it, I'll go with my Maruti with a 30 ka speed, but I will reach because this is where I would like to go. Sorry.
It was very beautifully explained. You know, this is the language we all get, you know, so cheeze itni simple cheeze tarike se samjhai jaye, it goes directly. Okay, yeah, this is the thing. So
see, the thing is, we just need to ask, hey, am I committed in creating my life? Or I'm committed in blaming why I can't have something in life.
Yes.
Because if it's committed, you will do whatever it takes. You're committed in blaming. You'll find all the creations possible where somebody is responsible why you could not have something or other. So when you're blaming somebody, you're not creating your life. Because when you create your life, you'll not blame. The only thing is, if you're judging, you have more allowance and say, hey, how can it be more easier in achieving what I desire to achieve? But we, how you initially said, we like our drama and trauma. We like our struggles. Because yes. If you don't have a struggle, I'll have no story to tell.
No. I'll be too boring.
It's like if I'm getting an Oscar award, how will I say what all I went through to reach and have this today? I can't say I was born with a golden spoon. I just got up from the bed and right directly I'm here to take this award.
Girls, I've raised my hand. I have a question.
Yeah.
Hi, thank you. This is, you know, you've been on a roller coaster while you were talking and it was so nice.
This is me. I'm always on a roller coaster line because I don't like snail movement.
I'm hearing you for the first time. I'm already like, you know, loving it. Okay, my question is something attached to what Priyanka said. So I'm following Axis and doing a lot of stuff. But the question here is, what will it take for me to, you know, say a no or draw a line is what is coming in my space right now to a person who's a very close relative. Okay. However, our energies have started matching again. Maine wo past event chhod diya jo bhi hua tha, and I'm on in sync with whatever is going on. However, today, you know, it's just a coincidence that today I'm talking to you, today this happened. I get a message, you know, I would appreciate if we still are a little apart. Aisa karke kuch aaya. I was like, all of a sudden, what is this? And I got very different kind of energy. And, you know, my body responded in certain manner and I sorted it. But my question to you is, instead of the story, the question is, what choices can I make? Because it's a family relation. Okay, Suruchi. What, and we live in the Indian environment.
I totally get it what you're saying when the family relationship is. So how sweetly can you say no? What if you don't have a blunt say? So sweet. Thank you so much for caring. I get it that sometimes it is. Let's keep a distance. You're so right.
I guess jo aap bol rahe, use a blunt knife. I can, you know, this is what I'm getting when you're saying the energy. But then I don't want to cut the cord. But if the other person wants to, then even I'll cut the cord.
No, why I'm saying don't cut the cord. No, you said I respect it. Let's keep a distance. So I so care for you and I appreciate your choices and decisions.
Okay.
So it's okay. Only stop because he asked you to stop or she asked you to stop.
And yes.
Always take, because it's just being an interesting point of view. Is that, yeah, I totally get it. You're so right. That's it.
Okay.
Make the person right, because everybody wants to be right.
You know what I wrote? Matlab mere ko sabse pehle access wala line. I said, interesting point of view. Sure, no, please, let's do that. Please, I wrote it clearly. And I was like,
interesting point of view in your head. Don't tell it to people because it's very rude. Because see,
that I know.
Saying interesting point of view and being interesting point of view is very different. When we are being an interesting point of view, there is no charge when somebody says something. When we just say for the heck of it, it's a useless tool.
Okay.
It doesn't change the energy, because your energy with that person doesn't change, because you're just using as an excuse and as a blame, right? But when you're being that energy of interesting point of view, you'll be like, yeah. It may be something going on in the universe. So it's interesting choices he's making.
And yes, it's a she.
So it is just that. And sometimes what happens is, like, when we can be actually be interesting point of view when we give up being right or wrong. And you can neither be right or wrong at any given point of time. It's just the situation varies.
Yes.
So what
the way our dynamics vary, even the other person's world and dynamics vary.
You don't know what
I get it.
You don't know what happened, what insecurity the person is going through that made him choose this. And and it is never about the other person. It's always about us.
Us. Yeah.
So what triggered you? If you have to see, you have to see what triggered in me, what it made me feel about me. And once you change that feeling, whatever she thinks, whether she wants to come back, she doesn't want to come back, she wants to keep distance, you'll have no point of view. You'll be like, hey, chill out. Whenever you want to party, I'm there to party. That's it.
I hear you. Thank you so much. It already, you know, changed the energy. Thanks.
Please be interesting point of view rather than just saying. When you
You know, there was some charge to it, Suruchi. That's why I brought it up. Some charge was there.
Of course. Yeah. So, and which is nice, I have gratitude for the person. Why? Because sometimes there's so many underlay point of view we don't get to know unless we are in a situation. Right?
Okay. Okay.
It's like you have a dress, you don't know that you have a dress unless they say, hey, dress code is this. We crib, oh my God, again, another dress code means another, I need to go and buy another dress. And then you open your cupboard, you're like, oh shit, this was there. I didn't realize I can wear this. It's not in my dress code. The same thing is, hey, thank you, XYZ. If you wouldn't have said this, I wouldn't have noticed that I have an underlining point of view. Now I can release it.
Yes.
It just worked.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Harshita has raised the hand. Yeah, Harshita.
Yes, hi.
Hi.
So my question is, living in a joint family, as I'm feeling like everybody is taking an advantage of me, and how I can cut that or stop that.
Great. So how you can ask, how can I take advantage of my mother-in-law? How can I take advantage of my father-in-law? What can I be in, do in here, which will create greater for us? So see, when you are not willing to take advantage of someone, they will take advantage of you. When you're not willing to manipulate something, they will manipulate you. Okay. But when we manipulate or take advantage, it's not like I'm stealing your money and going away. To create something, a greater relationship. To create something greater. Hey, what can I be and do here? Which will create greater for both of us. When you be in that energy, your tone, your way of talking, everything will change. Right? So you have to say, okay, why do I allow them anybody to take advantage of me? Why do I allow anybody to take advantage of me first place? And then the thing is, how can I take advantage of this situation, the joint family, right? We because it's like, how can I take advantage of it? Because I created it, right? How can I take it to create something greater for me, my family, for my kid, for everybody? When you start being in that question, a different energy starts peeping in. Because if you have already concluded that, hey, they take advantage of me, and because if I'm in a joint family, I don't, it's not a creative energy. I don't have my freedom. We have issues, okay? And you can say, hey, it's easy for you to say because you come from a nuclear family. Agreed. But then the thing is, whatever given situation I have a room, which is like, say 500 square feet. How can I beautify that? That it gives the essence of me staying there. I cannot change it. I cannot move in. It's not practical, but here, what energies can I introduce? What objects can I introduce? What can I be? That this whole 500 square feet feels like me, okay? The same thing is, what can I be in the joint family? What can I be and do that will create greater for all of us? And how can I use my mother-in-law to my advantage? The moment you say my advantage, you know exactly what word to say, and she'll say, yeah, beta, you're right, just do it. It's a win-win situation because she gets the high, what she needs, you get what you desire. So it's a win-win situation for both the party. Does this contribute, Harshita?
Yes, it's contributing, but I'm in a mess right now.
See, this is what it is. See, it's like it is contributing, but in the mess because it didn't match the point of view that you expected it to be. The same thing is when they say or when you say it doesn't match the point of view they have. So what do they want to hear? What can I give them that they are happy to receive and they're happy to contribute to me? So you give them what they can receive and they will contribute what you will have to do. But then the thing is we'll say, but I am not like this. I am not a hypocrite. I am not a manipulator. I'm a very straightforward woman. Great. To tell me, do you speak the same language with everybody? No. So why will you have a same attitude with every relationship? Why will you not be that energy that will create, mutate, shift, change with every energies around you? So for that, you need to let go your labels, your definition of you, your conclusion, decision, and judgment you have already formed about your family, which doesn't allow you to change the shades. Yeah, Harshita. I caught you. I can see you smiling. There's something that is kind of melting in your universe that you got the light.
Yes.
I kind of gave you something that you were looking for. So you are kind of happy now.
Yes, yes. I'm happy. And definitely I'll manipulate and I'll do things. I got your point. But I'm feeling very heavy in my head.
You're feeling heavy if you let go your point of view. And if you have no point of view, no expectation of what they do. It is only that, hey, I need that house to buzz with joy energy. So what can I do here which will create joy? Because if there's joy in the energy, I'm being me. That's a fuel. So I'm not doing it for them. I'm actually doing it for me. So when you do everything in the house, you do it for you and not for others. How much light it is, even if they don't do it, you are happy because you did everything for yourself.
Right.
But we do it for others and then we get disappointed because we have an expectation and it doesn't match what comes back. And that's what it starts on piling. And one day, like a volcano, we burst.
Right. True.
So what if you do everything for you? Because they are an extension of you. Because the thing is, the vibration they will have in the house is where you live. So you will paint the color what will create happy. So you will be that energy which will create happiness for everybody. And you will do whatever it takes. You will be the manipulator. You will allow them to manipulate you, knowing that they're manipulating you. You'll do whatever it takes.
Right. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Welcome.
Love you.
Thank you.
Anybody else have any questions? Or else it's time for us to leave also.
And I would like to add here, Suru.
Something I just wanted to ask. I just came back. Yeah. Suruji, actually, now is the time for, I'm going to my mom's place and I'm meeting them after 2 years. And my weight has increased too much. And like, I'm so scared of the judgment that I don't want to go. Like, it is about the body image. I feel like resistance to packing also. Like, and upon that, yesterday, one insect has bit on my cheeks.
More things will happen. More things will have been there, done there. Believe me, trust me, more things will happen. And we'll have so many beauty spots also. It's like, okay, this was also needed now. Okay.
So more I was like reluctant to pack and so much scared. The more things are happening on my face and on my body.
Yeah, only one thing. What if your agenda is to have fun with your parents? If you move your agenda to having fun with your parents, then proving. Because what will happen when we go, we have all our reasons. Then they say, we'll say, hey, because of lockdown, you know, I could not walk. Because of lockdown, this happened. So yes. We are deciding because what you're doing is, knowingly, unknowingly, you have given them the role that they are supposed to play based on your two past experiences, right? What if you change your agenda and says, hey, yeah, mom, you're so right. I have put on weight. Yeah. Do you have? So when you don't fight, we'll say it for 30 seconds, a minute, and then it's done. B, if you make an agenda of how much fun can you have with your parents, what happens? For some reason, they will not have time to say. And then you let go your own judgment of your body. See, if I don't judge myself, like, okay, in the lockdown, I had put 10 kilos. Okay, what you're saying? Exactly, I felt in the sense because I was going to Delhi and I was like, oh my God. And when I reach, everybody in my house have lost weight. Okay. Because they were working on that and I was working on facilitation. So in my head, it my reason and justification I was giving. Yeah, but I was saving the world. So what if I don't lose weight? I was contributing, I was empowering and blah, 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 just to make myself feel good. I was not being honest with myself that, hey, my weight is troubling me. It's not that what people look and say. It's my own trouble because I like to wear certain clothes which I can't wear. I didn't like when I did a photo shoot. Before going, I just did a photo shoot. And when I look at the picture, I'm like, oh shit. And I said, please don't tag me. You take it, but don't tag me. Right? And I was like, see, if I'm not comfortable with my body, then what am I doing to change it? It's not for others. It's for my own sense that if I'm not liking it. But here, what is happening is we're having a fight and we don't change it because we want to fight our parents. That listen, I can still be comfortable with this weight. You have a problem. And when there's a fight, the peace is gone. Somewhere we are not fighting them, we are fighting ourselves. So if you have, then ask, hey body, can you guide me? And I do this trick, okay, it works for me. I say, hey body, can you look so sexy that day? Can you just shrink for the 10 days? I promise you, when I come back, I'll take good care of you. Promise, but just shrink. Can you just shrink? Don't look that big. And it works. Can you look more sexier? Can you do this body? Can you just make friends with body? And you can only be friend with somebody, and your friend can only help when you're not judging them. So you have to let go first the judgment out. And what, when you meet your parents, lower your barriers.
My mom is like the most, she will judge me the most.
How much fun can you have with your mom? And how much fun can you have lowering your barriers and energetically fucking with her limitations? Fucking with her points of view, energetically. And say, your mom's so true. I could not do it, mom. You're so, mom, look at me. I put on weight. I miss you so much. There was nobody to tell me I was putting on weight. You know, mom, even Sharad didn't say anything. I'm so glad I've come here. Mom, please take care of my health. Please tell me what to do.
Okay.
Can she judge you then? No, you've given her a job. Play it to your advantage.
Okay.
Mom, no, I'm best mom. I so miss you, mom. Look at me, what I've done to myself. I so miss you. Can you please tell me what to eat, mom? Can you please tell me? Can you please stop me? I know I love this. And you know, mom, you're the bestest. I so miss you.
Okay.
Now can you pack?
Yeah,
see, make a different agenda. Let go. It's like, have you seen a child? If they scribble, they also feel proud of their scribbling. Unless you don't tell them anything, they'll be like a proud creation. My body, I'm a proud creation. I was just seeing how that body looks like. What, how much are you putting on the weight to see what your client feels when they're overweight? How much you want to see what the other, what judgment it is, how much you want to test your own water with the weight that you're putting? What if you don't have to go through anything? Here I can blame karma. I did all that in other lifetime. This lifetime I choose not to do. You can use karma in your favor. So that's the reason I have a perfect body shape, size. Are you going to use that karma part in your favor rather than just pushing and punishing you?
Okay. Yeah, thank you. No,
love your body and simple clearing. Release the judgment that you're putting, all the feelings that you're locking into your body, release that. Because what is happening is when you go, they can only read that insecurity, they can only read that judgment, because that is what will pinch on your forehead. Like how many times when we meet somebody and the person says, hey, what happened to your cheek? And you're like, they can't they see my dress? Can't they see? They have to only see the spot. Because you are focusing only on that spot, your energy is saying, hey, I'm here, look how ugly I look. And that's what they're giving you. So when you let go of that, and when the canvas is clean, can anybody say what color it is? No, unless you don't paint it. So what colors of energies are you painting in your universe, in your body, that when you meet the person, they pick up that color and says, hey, it's red. And you say, why did you say red? But you painted yourself red. Duh. So this is exactly what it is. If today you're saying, Suruchi, you're wearing a red lipper, I say, can't you see my earring? Can't you see my hair? Can't you see this? But what did I do? I painted my red so bold that the first thing you'll notice is the red, right?
Yes.
The thing is, you're painting your emotions so big that when your mother meets, she'll forget to ask, how are you? How's your family? She'll say, hey, what did you do to yourself? And that is what the recorder, it's like you're going on a trifold sequencing recorder again and again, playing the same record again and again. So everybody's going to hear the same music that you're playing, because that is your favorite music right now. Time to change the music.
Yes, 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 that's true. Day and night, I'm thinking about that only.
So day and night, think yourself on a beach, skinnier, juggling, and thousands of people are saying, Priyanka, come to us. And you're like, no, baby, I'm on a run. If you have to imagine, why wouldn't we imagine this? Why torture?
Yeah, it's true.
But what do you love about torturing yourself, Priyanka? Your life can't be so easy. You have to have a problem, sweets.
Probably, yes.
How much can you kill your mom with your smile? Why will you not smile like this, that she doesn't see anything else?
No, because it is in my head that she will ask that, and she asks that only exactly whenever I reach.
So now you know. Now you know, instead of thinking about it, instead of what, take that half an hour, whatever emotions are coming, pull it out, clear them so that your space becomes empty and fill with joy, fill with fun, fill with those memories of your mom, which is so much fun. And you think about that, then when she meets, she wants to do those activities with you. It is whatever you will do, she will see that. Like, what movie are you playing in your screen? I'm only witnessing that. So clear all your doubts, fear and everything, and fill with those intimate moment with your mom, the fun, the joy moment with your mom. So when she meets, she's like, you know what I miss? Let's go. Let's eat this. Let's go have fun. And I was unnecessarily fretting about it. You can change. You change the movie that you're playing in your head.
Yes, I'll do that.
And thank come you. To your body and just say, body, can you tell me ways where it will be fun for us to release all that excess, unnecessarily weight feelings that we've been carrying?
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Great.
Thank you so much, Suruchi. Today, you know, there was so much going in my world since few days. And today, each and every line and a word which you were saying, believe me, it was kind of, you know, you are facilitating me. And I'm feeling so light today. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
So much melted in my universe. Exactly. Yes. Thank you.
So grateful. See, this is what is, energy is the first language, right? So I'm only picking up things from your head. I really don't know, because I didn't plan what I have to come and say. So this is exactly what it is. If something is not working, just shift the energy, and so that you can attract things what will work for you.
Thank you so much, Suruchi. It was blissful. It was actually blissful. Thank you.
Thank you.
So anyone has any question? I think it's almost the time.
Yeah.
Khushi, you had a question? She was raising hand for quite some time. Do you have?
I'm not having any question yet.
So great. Because I saw your hand raised somewhere. I was like, okay.
You might answer her already.
Okay. Thank you so much. And thank you so much for giving this platform. It really means a lot. And guys, let's have fun. Let's create the
life you
desire.
Thank you so much. Thank you for being here.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Prati Didi and Priyanka Di.
And sharing such a wonderful insights, you know. It was wonderful, wonderful listening to you. Thank you. So we'll leave. Yeah. Bye.